Mr. Rubini, we have in Davos this year a quite positive sentiment. That's our feeling.
Yes.
What's your perspective, your outlook for the global economy at all for this year?
Well, there are some positive trends and also some downside risks. The positive is that global economy is growing. The risk of a double dip recession is lower. Corporates are flush with profits and cash. Emerging markets growing robustly. And now there is an increase in asset prices and stock markets that is improving financial condition. Those are the positive. There are some negatives. The negatives is there are still the problems of the periphery of the Eurozone. Ireland, Spain, Portugal, Greece, potentially other countries. That's one risk. Second risk is oil, energy, food prices are going up. It's causing inflation, it's causing reduction in income, it's also causing political instability. What has happened in Tunisia, in Egypt, is in part related to the rise in oil and commodity prices. So we have some beneficial trends, but there are also a number of risk downside. And within those downside risks, even the United States is growing now, has high unemployment rate. The housing market is double dipping. We have our own state and local government that are having severe fiscal problems, similar to those of Europe. And our federal government has a huge $1 trillion budget deficit and is not doing much about it. So things are improving, but things could also go wrong.
Do you still believe in the euro? Would you, for instance, buy government bonds from Greece right now?
Well, I wouldn't buy. I think that, of course, we know that in the periphery of the Eurozone, there are some countries that have a lot of budget deficit, a lot of stock of public debt, and I think that the orderly market-oriented restructuring of the debt, at least of Greece, is going to be necessary to avoid something more disorderly. Greece is a situation in which even if you do everything right, their public debt is going to be, at the end of the day, 150% of GDP. That's not sustainable. So an orderly and constructive restructuring has to occur, in my view, sooner rather than later.
Do you still believe in the Fed and in Ben Bernanke? Do you expect a QE3 maybe in this year, 2011?
Well, I don't know about QE3, but just today, they decided to maintain QE2 and do the full purchase of $600 billion of treasuries that they announced. So there is monetary stimulus in the United States. We decide to have a further fiscal stimulus in terms of tax cuts. The economy is becoming more robust, but as I said, the housing market is in trouble. The jobless rate is still significant. Some banks are in trouble. So it's still a difficult situation. It's not out of the woods fully.
A final comment on the biggest risk right now you are facing. Do you see commodity prices as the biggest risk or the rising oil price right now for the global economy?
Well, two types of risk. The rise in oil, energy, and food prices is a big risk. And on the other side, the sovereign debt problems in advanced economies and the specific problems of growth, lack of competitiveness and sovereign debt and deficits in the Eurozone in the specific are things we have to still worry about. The periphery of the Eurozone is still fragile. Three out of those five countries are still contracting, Greece, Ireland and Spain, and two of them, Italy and Portugal, are barely growing. We need growth because if there's not going to be growth in the periphery, eventually there'll be a political backlash against austerity, against these economic reforms.
Are you bullish for stocks right now, for equities at all?
Well, I think this year could be a positive year overall for equities globally, given global economic growth, if we resolve some of those downside risks, the Eurozone, oil, energy, food prices, downside risks coming from the U.S. There are also a number of geopolitical risks out there, North, South Korea, Israel, Iran, terrorism, cyber terrorism, Afghanistan, Pakistan.
It sounds skeptical again.
Well, you know, you have to think about the upside and you have to think about downside, and it's a balance between the two.
But a double dip scenario is not really realistic, or could it happen maybe in the U.S.?
Double dip in the U.S., I think at this point is a low probability, but the risk of a double dip, for example, in the United Kingdom is serious given what they have been the fourth quarter number, and in the periphery of the Eurozone is not even an issue of a W, it's more like an L. The risk they end up like Japan in a long-term stagnation unless they make the economic reform that sustain and restore economic growth. That's a risk for the periphery of the Eurozone.
Thank you very much, and have a good time here. Good meetings in Davos, Mr. Rubini. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.